Hey crypto YouTubers, this is coinpicker.us and wow, I have been slammed and not very good about posting videos, but I'm going to correct that right now. So I've got some news we've got to cover, got a quick update on the Bitcoin price, not a whole lot of surprises there, and then we're going to talk about one of the themes that I've been covering for a while that is just really showing amazing strength. So stay tuned. Welcome back. Let's dive into where Bitcoin is on a monthly basis. We've got a very weak trend for a downward move on the weekly basis. I say weak trend because I've switched out the EFI to use the average directional index. And as we get down below 20, it's a very weak trend. As you can see up here, it's a relatively high trend. But this is just indicative of what's going on. If we look at on monthly basis, this is actually a very strong downward trend that we're seeing. That's, I know, not the news that anybody wants to hear, but when I had made a video about there being a short squeeze in the market, that's sort of what I was talking about. And I think we're going to have to wait a little while. Basically, the news that took the wind out of the sails of the market is right here. U.S. SEC postpones decisions regarding Bitcoin exchange ETF. When and if an ETF hits, and I believe it will, but when and if an ETF hits, the market is going to just stair-step function higher, significantly higher, because the amount of money that can come into an ETF, even at a limited basis, with the multiplier effect of the last dollars in setting the price, it could lift the market value up. But it's not going to happen just yet. This is a typical summer behavior. I can't tell you whether it will happen. I can tell you that it is quite likely to happen because a lot of big players are looking for a new market. So That's the upside of it. Now, in terms of this actually is the dollar index chart. Here's the Bitcoin chart. Yeah, this is the right chart. We do have a very strong downward trend in place. That's what the ADX is telling us. The CCI says we're not close to reversal on it, and the RSI can hang out in this area for a very long time. So on a monthly basis, it appears to me that we're probably going to trend in this area, maybe drop a little bit lower just because the CCI is showing that, but we're going to trend in this area. I'm going to be monitoring the ADX to determine the strength of that trend over time. Now, on a weekly basis, we've got a shallower trend. We are not really in a reversal pattern here, and we aren't quite in a reversal pattern here, though we're not far from it. All of this is to say we're probably going to remain in a fairly narrow channel. That's what it looks like. And we've experienced that before. Now, if we take a look at Ethereum, USD, which is sort of a proxy versus all altcoins, it's actually getting primed for a reversal. Not quite there, but it's sort of primed for reversal. Of course, it has been dropping. LTC is probably dead in the water as usual. Let's just check that. On a weekly basis, it is definitely primed for reversal, but then again, what isn't? On a monthly basis, it's not quite there. And the downward directional trend is fairly strong in it, so I don't see anything really really of great news for trading. Now, EOS, of course, doesn't have good monthly data. Let's check it on a weekly basis. It's not quite. Now, the downward trend is weakening, so it is getting set up for reversal. We're just not there. But it's been in a downward trend for quite a while. But the downward trend is weakening. We could see, it appears to me that we will see some more downward move, but not a tremendous amount before we get a fairly good reversal in EOS. But EOS, as well as the entire market, has to wade through this period of indecision with the SEC. Now, let's go to something else that I've been talking about, where we're basically living in the anti-dollar environment if we're in the Bitcoin world. In the anti-dollar environment, the dollar has rocketed back up. It was down at, I think, 88, 89, which is a reasonable session. And that was a while ago. That was a while ago. So we're back up to 95 and getting ready to peak. At least on a monthly basis, the RSI is definitely overextended. We're not too far off from somewhat of a peak. Now, as shown with the directional index, it's a weak uptrend. See this? This tells us it's a weak uptrend, and we're getting into the peak zone. We're not quite there, but this this is showing we're in the target zone for reversal that I've been talking about for a while. The CCI is not quite there yet. It could go on for a little while longer, but you don't typically get massive up moves from these regions, especially not with an ADX down here. So when that reverses, we could begin to see Bitcoin, gold, other things begin to catch a bid. Now let's go back and talk about a theme that I've been bringing up for a long time. Let's go to commodities. Okay. Now, wheat has been on a tear, and it will continue to be on a tear. In fact, all food will eventually be on a tear. All softs. And that's one of the things I've been talking about. It is a sleeper market and has been for a while. They're still relatively cheap. Almost all softs are relatively cheap compared to where the S&P is at. And that's the method to use. If you look at the major indices right here, you'll see that NASDAQ has managed to creep up to a relatively close new high. Dow is doing slightly less well. S&P is up there. Small cap has been doing relatively well. I mean, you can just see basically, let's go out a year here. So we're near peaks. Dow has definitely dropped. Oop, I didn't want to do that. NASDAQ has, let's see what we've got here. NASDAQ is just a little bit below its latest peak. My expectation is that later on this year, we should see a fairly significant drop in the market. That's my expectation. The housing market has already begun heading down, and there are certain indicators that I follow that are suggesting we will begin to see. Of course, the interest rates are going up. It is a major drag on the stock market. But we've already seen a narrowing of the breadth of the market, and the NASDAQ took a major hit, especially when Facebook took a nosedive. And as I had mentioned a while ago, I said Netflix was an indicator of what's going to happen with NASDAQ. So all of this is tied together because Bitcoin and the entire crypto space is somewhat of the anti-dollar. NASDAQ stock market, everything else in the U.S. stock market, is founded on the dollar to a certain extent. Now, the Treasury, let's see, we don't have it. Let me see if I can look that up for us. The 10-year. I think the 10-year has actually crested 3%. There we go. I'm not sure. I thought it had. Okay, it was just up, in the near zone of 3%. It's in the near zone. If we go to 1 month, let's see here. Yeah, it's not quite there at that point, but it was very, very close. So we're creeping up. We haven't quite made it up over 3%, but the pressure, because of the debt levels and the bid to cover ratios in the bond market, the pressure is to raise, or to basically lower the price of the bonds and raise the yield. And the dollar, when the Fed eventually craters, which is likely to happen. Now, I want to hold out something that is kind of big, and I'm going to cover this in depth for my subscribers. Let me just put this out there. For those of you who are on my email list, I will be sending out an email update fairly shortly. But for those of you who are not, you just go to coinpicker.us and just fill this in, and I will go ahead and start sending you market reports. But anyway, what's happening is that there is a potential and sort of a rumor that there's going to be a realignment of the dollar, a realignment of the Fed. Now, Trump is already going to be able to apparently name several other people to the Fed and essentially take ideological control over it, but that doesn't mean that he really controls it. And I'm not saying that he will fully be able to control it. It's a very risky proposition. Those who have tried have often been, let's just say, dealt with. So hopefully that happens, but if it does, there's going to have to be a realignment. And the typical realignment is this: devalue, lock in a value. So you devalue the currency relative to some fundamental value. That fundamental value could be barrels of oil. It could be gold, it typically is. But that looks like it may be in the works. I'm going to be monitoring it. I will be updating it. But in terms of making money, right now the crypto space doesn't look very positive for that. Although, of course, you can build positions. Buying gold and silver, almost always a relatively good idea. And even though it's been a very weak July and August going on right now, they're holding their own and more than likely will catch somewhat of a bid going forward. The softs, the commodities like wheat, soybeans, pork bellies, a lot of those kinds of items, and commodity funds are really seeing beginnings of momentum develop and will be very, very positive going forward. Even the Bitcoin or even the crypto tokens that are associated with producing commodities will also potentially see a bid. So that's where the activity is in the market, where the low risk is for the high profit potential. The high risk is in the general stock market indices. It's where all the risk is right now, where we're flying at ridiculous price to earnings multiples. The real estate market is at ridiculous multiples relative to the earnings capacity of the people trying to buy the homes. That's high risk environment. If you have money to deploy, you don't deploy it there, in my opinion, other than places that I've already mentioned where you can get high dividends like 9% plus. You deploy it in areas like commodities, as I've been talking about, where it's relatively low risk to the downside and relatively near term, as in a couple of months, a year or year and a half, something like that, massive, massive upside. So I'm going to be sending out a update to my subscribers. If you've gotten any value out of this, please give a thumbs up and subscribe. And it's coinpicker.us signing out.